Alright. Still don't know what was wrong with my YouTube thing yesterday. Maybe my stream key changed. Yesterday maybe. Hello. It's very nice to see you, of course, Nico. Okay, refresh interface. I don't know why this would even. No, got it. All right. Require warming up once again, probably. At least a little bit. Because my god, it never works. When I just jump straight in, I was supposed to get quite a bit of practice just walking backwards and forwards from the elevator, and I inevitably don't get wealth for 10 minutes. It's bound to help me a little bit. They died, but they were completely stood up still. It's awesome. My goodness me. Actually went for it. Not that it really matters to me at this stage, but certainly a question that needs to be answered at some point about this game is where do all the weapons keep going when you can't find them? I think the answer is through the floor. Okay, there we go. Feel pretty good actually because I did some yesterday, so I feel too out of breath. If that works, I'm just gonna keep going anyway, whatever. Well, okay, sir, I don't want to alarm you too much. Guess I'll die then. Oh, God damn it, no. Where's the woman with the bat, as usual? Am I being daft? What happened? Doesn't matter. Let's just go. They've preemptively got cups of tea. Or one, in fact. As nice as the reward was, it was kind of difficult to interrupt things like that. I could just have a stretch and equally get the same amount of rest and relaxation from it. Oh dear. That clip I got yesterday was properly funny. Sorry, going through the walls like that. Yes, I don't know if Trident would be bothered if I end up getting a record that uses out of bounds stuff, but I'm going to try and continue to use it in these sets of attempts if I can, wherever possible. Because it has potential to save a couple of minutes. It's really big, and you get to keep all your money. It's really the best part about it. If it works out perfectly, that is, of course. Which it might not. Thank you for the praise, Tinnick. I may need that, to be honest. This is usually the segment where I spend 5 or 6 minutes. Until I get wealth. And it doesn't need to be wealth, really. I can't just start doing lots of runs and hoping it works out later on. It's waste loads of my time. Probably. Where's my best segment for that? Is it like... No, it's not one second. That's not possible. It's not 1 second. I think my best segment ever was about 58 seconds or something. I'm just going to put that in. Because I don't... It's not 0.36 seconds. It's not really reasonable, is it? Let me just come up with an imaginary one for this. That could probably be like 120. I'm fed up with the time accounting down immediately. It's too stressful and too difficult. My god, 33 seconds. That's actually probably what it is. Best segment, 1 minute. Wait a minute, what? Oh yeah, of course. That's actually irrelevant, isn't it? Just say that's what it is, probably. Fucking hell. 4.5 minutes on that. In my main. How did that even happen? It's incredible. How on earth did I get one run with that? I've got a tab, so I can't do any of this for a while. That's what it was last time. I was just doing this for about 20 minutes. Oh, I'll go for this. It needs to be wealth, doesn't it? So little commentary I can do in this section, really. I wish there was more, but it's resetting for wealth. Just even though I've got a simulation, I'm not happy with that. Means a run is more likely to not fail at some point between now and the necromancer, but not that much more likely, to be honest. I think if you're gonna die, you're gonna die with that. After a long enough time, you do get substantially more health, of course, but never feels like enough anyway. those swirlies and you think it might be wealth for a brief moment. A brief, glorious moment where it looks like it could be anything, but no. You can't actually have it. Goodness me, stop giving me flawless technique. I just need a little bit of help. A very small amount of help. There needs to be one perk. Very particular perk. Maybe getting the upper stack and getting multiple perks is actually a really good use of the shards. It's a good use of time. It's a debate to be had, I guess. Chocolates probably give you a bit of gold, do they? I don't actually know, really. It's been so long since I did this super casually. Should pass that, I'm not going to. No, now I'm going to. I don't know why I quit there. There we go. Always, grass is always greener, obviously. Not actually a motto for life, but there we go. What is with this incredibly long set of corridors? Again, the key is gone. That's not bad. Backwards again, how about that? Can't reach that before. I can probably very nearly reach the down area, but not quite. Didn't quite work out for me there. It would be a one-way, wouldn't it? Yeah, I can probably find better weapons than that preemptively. Apparently, that's not enough these days. These new Gen Z minions don't die to a shovel to the head. What the hell? I need to actually get gold from them. Jesus Christ, then. That might be doable. Okay, towards a downwards area? No. Different one. Together. probably actually going to lose time with this strategy, but there we go. It happens. Hope I don't have to go through there. That would be a pretty big disaster, to be honest. Considering my current red. Full health replenishment. I probably should have used the black skeleton man with the stuff. I don't quite think it's a good sign. Of course, you would have that one right afterwards, wouldn't you? Is that another one? Oh no. Good, but. It's also frustrating that I have been so inconsistent with it. So one of the nice things about having both of them on the ground floor is you can kind of go towards both arrows. And it sometimes is very useful. It's like triangulation, but not really. Can't get through here, that's a relief. Quite a serious relief, actually. You must be joking. What just happened? Why is this the longest Crystal Caverns one ever? Do I say that every time? Probably. Every once in a while you realise there are actually speedrunning things built into this game. Like dropping weapon you're holding is genuinely quite a on-the-go thing. Alright, Trident is the first one I've had a wealth in, or a perk that I could use actually. I passed up an opportunity to use a simulation, but other than that, about it. I think I also started a run and got trapped immediately, so. This one's fine. It's not great. Obviously, never great, but. Gremlins on this one, which is good, but I haven't found any more Crystal Caverns so far. A little bit of time to change that, I guess. hope it's in here. Oh, I think it's going to be in the room to my left, isn't it? Almost certainly. Damn. I've wasted a bunch of time on that. But anyway, yes, not too bad. Could be worse than sight, I guess. Certainly could be plant bomb. Cage match every time. We love getting the cage matches. Now, did the shop have to be this nearby? That's quite unfortunate. Oh wait, is it a bit further away than I think? It's another cage match. Let's get round and to the right, surely. You'd think, wouldn't you? And is there one more room on the way? There is one more room next to it, kind of. We don't need much more game, come on. Mistake. We're gonna do it anyway. This thing I'm hoping will survive about as long as it usually does, which is good. The pursuit on my left in this hallway goes on for 1,000 years. Fantastic, he's never gonna fucking arrive now. Seriously, what is this hallway? It's only going away from the pursuer at full speed. I'm just going back here to catch it, I think. Predictable enough, yes. God damn it. So frustrating. Hello, Kitty. What the fuck is wrong with this ruins layout? I can only go away from everything I need to go. The hell? PTTR? I've already gone in here as well. Not even the worst part. Oh, for God's sake. No, this is incredible. It's only a way. Oh, thank you. That'll be useful. I don't think there's any point in continuing this, really, unless I can get lots of money really quickly. It's only taking me away from it. What is happening? I really don't like getting frustrated with this game, but it does seem to really, really hate me at times. Why is this the worst Ruins 1 I've ever seen? Of all the things. It's just so far away from me now. I'm back where I started. This is impossible. That's literally the entrance. Oh, God. No, this is ridiculous. I have nothing that can be salvaged from that. Obviously, that'll take me another 2 minutes to get over to the exit. Of course. It's bloody hard to survive the ruins. Because it always generates awfully for some reason. I don't know how it happens to me so much, but most of my runs end there, really. I mean, I never really die before that. I think I did once last stream, but I wasn't really paying attention. I'll claim I wasn't paying attention anyway. super tedious. Sometimes with enough gremlins, it's continuable. Oh god, not if I lose to every zombie. So I think the X is right here, that's not good. Need a gremlin on the way, hopefully then. It's so fragile, no! Stop! Fairly ridiculous run. Fairly ridiculous, anyway. I just, it's outrageous RNG. I'm never gonna get it, am I? It's just not gonna happen. I could have more time in my 120-second challenges that I keep getting. That would be a worthy thing to bring beneath. I wonder if maybe that halves the time or something, because why would it make you survive longer? The game also wants to keep you like that, in that area, for as long as possible, because it spawns in new enemies and stuff. What I often do now is if I've got a good power and a gremlin right off the bat, then I'll keep going, but other than that it's not really worth it, because you might not get the gremlin and you've wasted a couple of minutes, and you could equally spend that couple of minutes trying to get wealth 1, which would be really useful. So like there we go. Every time I'm talking about it, I seem to get it now. That's not actually a katana. Kinda looked like it. Oh my god, why am I doing this? Why am I doing this? Just kill the goddamn crystal crab, why? It takes so long. Also, I think that this is actually through an apostate again. And I've got wealth. This is probably the 15th consecutive time. How is this possible? Every time. I'm not going through that. It takes ages. It's just, there's millions of enemies in the corners every time. Oh, I don't understand. It's incredible. Oh, don't worry, I got brass knuckles. I'll save everyone today. Not at all. Okay, neither, really? Really? There's no enemies, and the enemies that are there are invulnerable. What just happened? What just happened? On pace with trying, I just probably have less money than he did at this point with the lack of gremlins and all that. Oh, he just blew up when I killed. What? Didn't I just come from here? I said one of them probably would kill me, but didn't. You are literally guaranteed a gremlin every one. How is it so frequent that I don't find them? I feel like I really only find them half the time, when it should be way higher. Also, this kind of bullshit keeps happening to me again. Maybe I'll get a spawn here that will allow me to do the thing. Oh, for God's sake, dude. No, it's actually not that bad of a spawn for this. It will depend quite sincerely. It's put me just a bit to the left. Great, what the hell is wrong with this? Exit is so far away that it won't even, like, render in. Why does that happen? That shouldn't happen. I have abomination. I'm having a horrible time with this at the moment. I'm getting nothing on my side. I've got wealth twice in as many minutes as you'd expect, but the rest of it has been appalling. Everything has been against me today so far. I thought the ruins were going okay on that previous wealth one. It was very average. But then ruins just was the worst ruins I've ever had. It was the most biggest maze. Different joints and everything. It was crazy. Yes, that basically is the speedrun, indeed. I'm not interested. God damn it! Can they stop bothering me? Goodness me! Just running around randomly, leaving whenever I don't want them to. I do not want that to perk. It's hopeless. It does nothing if you're a Spectre. So many of the perks do nothing if you're a Spectre. They rely on you taking damage in the first place, which you can't afford to do unless very rarely. I've had no gremlins so far on this run. What are the hell? What the fuck are the odds that I just genuinely don't see one? There's no chance. I don't know why this is happening. Oh dear. No! I don't understand this! I was leaving completely in my. In my mind. Flipped around. Some godforsaken reason. Oh my god, I never ever get good generations. I don't know, even in my PVs, my generations are very poor. The only thing that saved my last PV was how good the Trickster construct path was basically perfect. Everything else was absolutely rubbish. Very average or very below average. Is all of this blocked off as well? I think this is basically impossible to continue, unfortunately. No gremlins, no generation, nothing that's worked at all. Yeah, I don't know. No, they do exist. Because Trident seems to get them in most of the records. I've occasionally got them in previous PBs, it's just my last one was... I don't know. Didn't seem to have a lot. I mean, goodness me, the Ruins 1 and Ruins 2. Those are the most important ones, if those are good. You get no cage matches, and the enemies you fight are mostly interceptors. Things like that. And the path, and you find a gremlin. On the path, there's a shop that's mid-range on Ruins 1, and then the exit is quite nearby, and you have Wealth 1 by then. Absolutely perfect. And you can't have too many cage match rooms, because they're a disaster. Even though you end up killing a lot of enemies in them, they're not. And then you need no cage matches at all on Ruins 3, and for it to be as short as possible. Ruins 2, you need it to be a lot of rooms that aren't cage matches as well, but are full of enemies, but not too many. But I needed to be not statues in the cage matches, if there are any. But they usually are. So, well, usually one for me, at least, in the stream. I disagree with that, actually, but that's just, you know, the map generation dictates how much money you can get at any given point. Depends on the types of enemies you get very strongly as well. You need giant mages and interceptors to give you the most junk. Oh my god. If your Ruins 3 generation takes 4 minutes, then you've lost 4 minutes. If the necromancer's just on a straight path, you will save 4 minutes. It's, you know, the generation will ruin the run if it can, and Ruins 2 is kind of the same, but you need a few rooms with lots of enemies, is my point about that, I think. No, but Trident, I don't think you're understanding my point about this. The rooms dictate the amount of enemies that you get, and if you just get the perfect amount for Wealth 1 or 2, then it's... Then there's your money. Yeah, of course, I understand that. With the money, you don't need any in Ruins 3, but... In Ruins 1 and 2, if you get too many cage match rooms, then you have too much money. That it's like Ruins 2, you want to spend absolutely all of your money, so you need a perfect amount, or you need a, even slightly less, and then you just kill all the enemies. But if you get three cage matches with statues in, and you can't survive them with your weapons, then the generation has ruined everything. And that happens to me like every time I get to Ruins 2, it feels like, nowadays. Anyway, sorry. I think the money is very important. Obviously, that's very clear. But I think that it's just so tied to how the map generates and to gremlins, of course. You need millions of gremlins wherever possible. I don't know if, like, the generation can really ruin your run. It can really screw you over. I think maybe I'm thinking about that aspect of it too much, but in Ruins, you can have really, really bad Ruins. But there's always some enemies to kill in Ruins along the way, unless the generation is perfect and you get them the correct number. Oh, for God's sake. The money is kind of fine if you get wealth. If you don't have wealth, then it becomes very difficult. Time to kill the enemies you see with wealth, and then you'll have enough almost all the time. But they're both very important. Yes, that's the takeaway. I think they're both quite crucial. Oh my god! Come on, man. I wonder how linked the gremlin is to what room it's in. Probably not, if it's turning to be believed, then it's completely random. But I always feel like I find him in rooms with more people. It might not actually be true, but I feel like I'm always fighting millions of things trying to get him. And of course you're not meant to be able to get the gremlin in hallways, but you find him in hallways quite a lot in ruins, in my experience. Well, not quite a lot. About as much as you find him in rooms, in my experience, anyway. So, That could be an oversight, or the hallways are treated as rooms, or maybe he can actually move into the entrance of the hallways as well. The zone is just a bit poorly defined or something, I don't know. The ruins is one of the only areas where the rooms are sometimes a very weird shape, if you want to avoid the wall. And crystal caverns, actually, sorry, I shouldn't say that at all. But I'd never find them in the walls and crystal caverns, it's really weird. Or in the walls, or in the halls, even, sorry. You've got money going into ruins, you can just use speed rushing to the exit, only killing Kate. Yes, but your money is determined by the generation of the previous place. I don't, like, this is my overarching point. If your generation's terrible, you find no enemies, or you get locked into three cage matches and then there's nothing else, and your money is screwed. There's nothing you can do. Yes, I know finding the exit's a lot easier, but the three cage matches that you can be put into, you might not find them if you have loads of money in ruins too. Like, that's 3 minutes or so? Particularly if you break your weapon in any of them. I guess you have a black katana by then, it's fine, but that's pretty rare, especially with wealth too. You're very likely to not have enough energy by the time you're at that point. But also, there's no point in... Like, nowadays, you need wealth 1 at least. At least at some point on the first ascent, I think, to have a chance of the top spot. So... No, but you're right about the money. That's very true. I realise that fact. I'm saying that it's determined by the generation. Anyway, it's not meant to be a big overarching point. I think both could screw over. Oh, for God's sake, man. Never gonna get it again. Not true, man. I don't know what you mean. It's so determined by the generation. It's not directly, like, it's not just, oh, if the generation's good, then you get money, but there we go. Wealth doesn't increase the amount of gems you get, it just means you get the same amount, but because you need to kill a certain number of enemies, you need to kill more enemies to get the gold to open the doors. So then you end up with more energy if you kill more difficult enemies. And therefore, your energy is a little bit better if you don't have wealth, but you take longer overall. So you can probably get your first katana upgrade straight away without wealth, like possibly even entering ruins if you're really lucky. That's if you kill enough enemies anyway. But if you have wealth, then you get less energy because you don't need to kill as much stuff to get the gold to open the doors. So then your upgrades take longer. And that does slow you down a bit, but obviously if you find a regular katana when you go into the Trickster Descent, then you're fine. There's nothing that you need a black katana for, particularly, as long as you keep getting... Yeah, I think it's not really... But what do you think does affect money? Because money isn't a thing by itself. That's the enemies have the money, and then it depends on what enemies you run into, which is part of the generation of the levels. If you just keep running into statues forever and you don't have a katana, which is part of the generation. Sorry, the generation's a big thing that I'm trying to, like, to discuss. I think it's, the RNG needs to be good, basically, is the trouble with this. And right now, I have not got wealth in about 10 minutes. This is ridiculous. Why is this happening? Or even a perk and a nearby gremlin, which is obviously unlikely to happen. I realise it's actually much, much, much less likely to happen than anything else. But, yes. Yeah, I know, that's... I'm trying to get wealth, but it's just random, man. I know how important wealth is in this. I'm better than anyone, I think. Well, perhaps other than yourself. I don't know how much time you spend on this. Probably many hours. Like myself, I suspect. So far I've not had the foresight to carry a run all the way to the end, but... There we go. Can't believe how good my Trickster Mage was on my last PB. There's no gremlin again, I just want to... Yeah, I would continue if I had a gremlin there, would it be alright? I'd just say, right, we're going to see if we can get wealth later on from a skeleton. Or from the bridge, perhaps, which is, you know, never happens, but sometimes. But no, I can't even, like, I don't want to walk around, have a tower, have a banner generation, can't get the gremlin. Rick Cave's one is very short. So it not, there's not that much riding on it, but if you can get gremlin and lots of money straight away, it's excellent. I think, oh, right now I'm set up. The generation does matter. If you get wealth, you don't have to worry about money, so it's not that important. That's pretty much, like, money, it just comes to you regardless of the sort of... The generation can still ruin your run. I have it all the time. Well, it still takes minutes off of your time because you can't find anything. It's not usually something that happens. Usually wealth, you can just run around. But Crystal Caverns, you get really, you can have really, really bad rooms. I think I'm sure you know about that. Not usually minutes of time lost, but still. Not always. I know, yes, but not on the path to the exit, though. But this is my whole point. You don't always find the gremlin. You don't always find rusty katanas because the map hasn't generated them in your path, or has generated them off to the right, or hasn't generated it at all if it's a certain type of weapon. There's not always the right enemies. Usually there's lots and lots of very good stuff, but not always. Sometimes it does screw you over. It's very annoying that it's possible for that to happen, but again, it's a small chance, I suppose, of having really bad enemies. It's just not... It's still... It matters. You don't always get the things you need. Well, so I certainly don't, anyway. Be interesting if we needed to factor in shard lords into this run, because then it would just be like, oh no, I need a particular type of shard lord who I can kill in one hit, otherwise it'd be losing time. Actually, no, all of the shard lords are free after you get a black katana or even a normal enchanted katana. Or speed. They're all kind of fine after that. Oh man. God damn it. Bodyguard! No need for it. I did ask him the last time he was on this stream, actually, I think, possibly. Which was quite a while ago. I think he's lost interest in me. Oh no, he changed direction sharply. Sharpish. Would be a massive help, I would really appreciate it. And this is going to be a challenge through here, isn't it? I don't think it's going to be the correct path, I can probably go to the left. Look at that a lot, it just... Obviously, you don't really lose a whole lot of time by doing those, ultimately, but it's still, it is slower, because you can get things on the way. Please give me caffeine or something, that'd be good. That's not really that helpful, but okay. You can distract, I probably shouldn't have taken that at all, actually. It's usually not a big help. Really? Interesting. But I don't have like a DM with a turning sadly or anything like that. You know, Dark Quester does. One of the rare people who does, in fact, have DMs with various powerful people like that. I suppose it's probably just very hard to work on this game because of the Unity, but I can't imagine it'd be hard to. He complains about that a lot, so Nick, I don't know. That's annoying. Oh my gosh, why am I getting recruitment and bodyguard? I'm gonna have an army behind me at the end of this. This is gonna break soon, but I think it's still a good weapon to enchant, even if you've got a couple of hits. As long as it doesn't break straight away. We're fine. Look at that hallway. That's pretty good. Well, actually, we're not really sure if it's good yet. Might be a disaster. That was an awful decision to enchant that. I thought it was more drivel than it was. This will sound really entitled, but do you know what I mean when I say, like, you get annoyed by the gold on your face off the ground? I can't see anything for a second at all. It really messes with you. I'm like, oh, what's happened? Hang on, was that the drop down that I just ignored? Oh no, I think I might have ignored the room. Wait, I don't think so. What the fuck? What the fuck? That's where I was already coming from. What's going on? It must be through here. Oh, I missed the katana. Is it through here? Where is the drop down right now? Dude. What is going on? I've got more than enough money and I'm being really, really screwed over here. The absolute hell is wrong with this generation. Where do I go? There's just an endless loop in this area. Have I missed something really obvious? This is actually going to throw the runaway at this stage. Oh my god. There's no chance of me being able to do the out of bounds here either. It's way too far away. This is not the same path. At least it wasn't at first, but it just loops around. For fuck's sake! Is this seriously it? Like, I can't do anything here. I can't tell if this is a broken seed or if I've just missed something really obvious. Like going in the opposite direction at the start or something. I actually have no idea what to think about this one. Nope, there's no path through there at all. There's no path through here at all. Good. Good. That's terrible. What the hell was that? Goodness me. I have no words. I didn't need to erase the save there, actually. I shouldn't have bothered. Worst Caves 2 generation ever. That was Caves 2, wasn't it? Yes. Barely even got started yet. I don't know what was wrong with that one. I must have been missing something, I guess. I'll have to watch the VOD later. Did anyone see anything there that I missed? There wasn't a single path that I could follow. Everything just circled around. I must have. I don't think I've ever. I think once in multiplayer I had Beneath Caves break, and that's in multiplayer, which you'd expect. But I've never had. Crystal Caverns have had no exit before, a couple of times. But Caves is a bit more rarefied. You also got golden gloves as an ally you once recruited someone to. Alright, okay. Is that upgrade actually worth bothering with? I wonder if maybe that would allow us to get more gold in the speedrun. Is it 150 or something energy? It probably isn't worth it. You probably wouldn't get it until Fire and Blood at that stage, but certainly not worth having it over the katanas, so you'd have to go after 250 energy. Yes, maybe it depends a little bit. Maybe I'll try that in the next run that looks like it's going well. The last time you ever need to open any doors that cost money is the Caves 1, 2, and 3 doors, and that's on the way to the Aberration, so it's a bit sort of, those are quite cheap by that point, and you can get the gold quite quickly, but if you got the gold boxer, it would be even faster, I suppose. Maybe. Yes, it can't be hard to add something that would allow us to choose this perk. It is so much time that you're wasting on the on these runs because of this. Computer just revs up every time I go into Beneath. I go, oh, I'm generating a brand new world for you. Thank you very much, computer. I'm not going to see it. Tedious. Thank you, Abomination. Fortunately, I've got so much time waiting around, I've actually given that quite a lot of thought, and I'm sitting in a perfectly sensible position for once. But, oh, man. Oh, Jesus. Stretching a little bit. Okay. I go into gamer stance mode when I'm past the Necromancer, usually, which only happens occasionally. Always with the plant bomb. Got this like 4 or 5 times this stream. Enhanced time as well. I seriously do believe some perks might be more likely to come up than others. I'm not just saying that because of wealth. I'm saying I don't get the poisonous bottle thing, 20% poison chance, very much. I don't get the power modifier that gives you three mini bars instead of two. Sorry, I don't get that very much. I don't get assimilation very much. Everything else I think is pretty common. Like I get it far more than the others. Wait a minute, my sensitivity has just crashed. Oh, what has happened to my sensitivity? Did I press a button? A macro? That has ruined everything. Holy Jesus. That better not have happened. This feels about the same. Even the weapon durability thing I think is pretty common, really. I've got it 4 or 5 times this stream as well. As far as I'm aware, they're all equal chances. It just doesn't feel like it. I think another thing is that Eternic used to join in when I streamed later, for whatever reason. Maybe that's when he has the time to look around on Discord, perhaps. If I was still going at 2 in the morning, you occasionally tune into that. Could do that today, but it's going to be a hell of a lot of resetting for this particular perk. Ooh, there's a pretty moon out tonight, just out my window. I don't know, it looks very red, like a harvest moon or a blood moon. Whatever the Latin name is. Nice. No one can see that actually, that's a shame, but it's nice. Feels a bit like that Abomination, yeah. I don't really have the facility, like it's behind the trees and it's very dark, I don't think my phone will do a good job of that. Maybe there will be people on Twitter talking about it that I can go and find. But sorry, I can't do this. Everyone will, well, not everyone, two particular people will just insult me, I'm sure. Continuing. It's just has to be wealth, so you don't have to worry about money. You don't have to be concerned about needing to go into another room to kill enemies or something. The posture's pretty good, don't worry, thank you. It's going to be a tedious day, I think, possibly, with this, because I've not got it in ages now. Well, I got it with that Caves 2 generation, but it just sucked, or didn't work, or something. Recovery is barely even that useful for other classes. I wouldn't imagine it's much... Well, it's certainly not in use for Spectre. ...25% health is one hit from death from mostly everything. How do you feel about an ESA beneath our NG submission? Yeah, I've often thought about submitting beneath to these things. I think we actually tried to submit NG Plus, didn't we, at one point? Which they weren't massively interested in, if I remember. But I do actually... I would like to do that, because I can really quite reliably... I'm sure either of us could, either of us or possibly others could very reliably, with any perks they wanted, finish this game in an hour and a half. Even with pretty poor RNG, I think that eventually you can finish pretty much any run, anything can be done. Even if it's very scrappy. It's quite fun to think that I was having an hour and a half run of beneath quite recently. NG Plus is literally just, you start on a continuing save file, so you just have any amount of progress and you try and kill an Elder God. And that is... NG is longer and it can be better for a live stream and explaining stuff. Yeah, definitely. I think NG Plus, you go a bit too quickly to have a nice conversation about how the game works. And NG is fairly entertaining as well. You do some pretty fun roguelite stuff as well. Oh my goodness, we wouldn't show them this part of the run though, obviously, that would be silly. Just pick up whatever perk you get. If you did a race as well, that would be... if it was going to be ESA, it'd have to be Winter, because they're currently doing ESA. No, you've got to start in the Facility Abomination, but other than that, it's any amount of progress. I've never actually specified that in the rules, maybe I should do that. If there was a way of getting a laser katana first, that would be even better, but we can't do that without killing a Construct Pursuer. I've often wondered if we could get that into this speedrun, but I don't think you really can. The only way that I can see that you could do it is kill the Trickster third, and then you'd have to go through all of that, and then kill the Necromancer, and then you kill the end, which would take much longer, obviously. And is not worth the 3 or 4 minutes of time save you get in the final fight. As a result of having the laser katana. Oh, this is getting silly now. I've not had it for 15 minutes. I feel like that's about what that is, isn't it? Oh, god damn. If I don't get it in 5 more minutes, I'm just going to run 100% because this is so tedious. It's not even content, it's just resetting. I have 842 attempts. I expect that probably about 600 of them are just trying to get wealth, at least. Because a lot of these are from before I bothered trying to get specific perks, or trying to get, you know, specifically wealth, in fact. But yeah, it's just stupid the number of attempts that aren't even attempts, because you can't do it because you don't have wealth. It's a very rarefied market, though, asking for a change to this perk system, because... You know, I'm just glad that it resets on an abandoning the run kind of thing, and not you don't restart the whole save file every time. I suppose I'm glad it is this quick. But no, I think that having this at a marathon would be really fun. You could even just do an online one. I don't know if the travelling is really as fun as it is to go to Sweden and everything. I think it's there are a hell of a lot of marathons I'm sure that would enjoy having a game like this. Essentially, a lot of marathons have got the same crop of Sonic and slightly niche NES and SNES games. I suppose slightly niche. They're probably very popular in reality, but to me they seem pretty alien, or like you would have to have grown up with it to have heard of it. Certainly nowadays, any way you could hear about it is speedrunning. Possibly occasional YouTube content where it gets covered. I don't know, I can't think of what kind of games they are now, but that's what the big crop of games at marathons is quite like. They have interesting speedruns and everything, but this is something that's very lively and there's a lot to talk about, there's a lot to do, there's a lot going on, there's a lot of things that will be different on both of the screens, not just the same tricks. In fact, there are very few tricks at all. I have no idea about this. Just please. I've not gone wealth at all for ages. The laser katana does break, yes. It has slightly better stats than the black katana. You could quite comfortably, without enchanting it, get it all the way from Caves 1 to Ruins 3. And then it might break at some point in Ruins. That area. But if you enchant it, it's as good as invulnerable, really, for the any purposes of doing one descent into beneath. No, you can break it, I'm pretty sure. I've definitely broken one before. I was doing a mostly co-op beneath where I ever bother getting it when I'm doing beneath tutorials. I've tried two times to record a beneath tutorial in parts of it. One of them is a work in progress. Max durability upgrade. I mean, I don't think it'll ever be unbreakable because of the way that the game calculates things, but that it probably wouldn't break for a huge amount of time with all of the durability upgrades and the durability perk and things like that. And the enchantment, and you could even use the Vanguard on top of it. I don't think you could do that, actually, but... Then you pick a class that has particularly good durability usage and everything. Yeah, it probably lasts for ages, but I think it does eventually break. It's not massively better than the Black Katana, but it's definitely better. And of course you can kill pursuers with it, so that's... small advantage if you're a casual player, but as a speedrunner you just really leave or want them to come to you and they never do. Oh my god, beneath! This is not funny. I just wanted to get wealth again one time. To get an attempt in, but this is not working. Not one time I've had it in nearly 20 minutes now. That's hopeless. Sinking into my chair with despair about this. So many of these I've got loads of times in a row. Well, sorry, loads of times all together. Why can't wealth just be common? I wouldn't imagine it's even that good if you're trying to grind and make lots of progress in beneath. It doesn't give you more energy. Yeah, I know what you mean, Trident. I probably would have gone to this one if I had the money to do it, or if I was running anything. But the stuff I run regularly, I've already submitted and done all of, incidentally. Or not Paint the Sound Red, but I was happy to join in with when you did it. Maybe in a year or so they'd accept it again, I'm not sure. Did Paint the Sound Red UKSG? That was pretty good, UKSG, but it was a bad time of year for me to go. I had to do loads of exams and stuff right before and after it. And then I had to go on a coach, because that was the only affordable method of transport to Scotland. From where I live, and then it was pretty short as well, but it's quite a nice event. I actually really enjoyed sitting around and just occasionally talking to people and watching the runs. It's certainly much smaller than the ESA UKSG is and everything, but a coach, it's like a bus, if that's your confusion. Sorry, I assume that you mean you don't know what that is, but it's kind of like, if you're not sure what it is, it's a bus basically, but it's got slightly more comfortable seats, I guess. Okay, that's fine then. I didn't want to assume, but then I just did straight away. It's gone one hour and 10 minutes on stream, and I've not switched from this. So am I lying to myself? Alright, on this attempt, if it's not something good, I'll go with anything now, with something decent, as long as maybe a Gremlin in Caves 1. I just cannot bear to keep resetting this. It's so tedious. This is so dumb. No, it's nothing good again. What is the point? What is the point, guys? Just kill me. I don't want to live on this beneath anymore. Thank you. Yes, very kind. This game is much better casually, I think, probably, than speedrunning it. What do you think? Should I continue with this, or do 100% instead? I don't know if I'm really good enough to get the new 100% record, but we can give it a try. I guess I'll save my thousands of attempts on that. I need to come up with some new split names for this. All of them require Praying to Eternity now. It's no good at all. I don't know how these splits for like years and years. Need to warm up a little bit on some of the more sort of obscure maps in my mind. Hello, Carl Wilbert ONG again. It's nice to see anyone. And you, everyone, and anyone. Upstairs, children, you get a bunch of burly men trying to kill you for years and years. That is what happens every time. That wasn't a bad silly. Alright. Into the abyss we go. Yeah, I had another three or four minutes of just not getting wealth. I'm fed up with it. I had 20 minutes without getting it. It's just pointless. I'm just wasting my life with that one right now. Just for something different, I might go back to it in a minute. Depends how much this annoys me, to be honest. Usually it doesn't annoy me so much, this category. It's just like, it requires a lot of energy, I think, compared to beneath. Need to keep focusing, laser focus all the time, whereas quite a lot of beneath you is just essentially, there are a lot of times beneath where you need to focus, sorry, that's not my point, but my point is, this one, you need to be focused all the time, absolutely all the time. Goodness me, man. Something. That's one of the things of all time. My knife has just flown into the corner. What happened? What? Oh my goodness me. What? It's been a few years since I've seen that. Curious. Themselves. Oh my goodness. So red, it's a secret Easter egg. Just a few hundred hours of just constant painting the town red. That's all it requires. Why am I getting such absolutely rubbish katanas at the moment? This is an interesting problem to have. Usually they're not bad, but so far none of them even got to 9 left, I don't think. Which I probably should with the shockwave in combination. Oh my god, what am I doing? Dumb. Happens to you too, don't worry. That's nice and reassuring. I do know, don't worry, that it's... not just a problem with everyone. Not just a problem with me, sorry. This is a problem with everyone. It's like India's chest, still. How's he walking around? Okay, that guard has just taken about four bladed hits to the face. He's an absolute soldier. Just in case it works out somehow. Nope. Not much likelihood of that happening. Oh god, can I actually get that now? Nope. No, is the answer to that. Yeah, I shouldn't have done that. That was a bad idea. Yeah, I know, Trident. I was just hoping that they would kill him as an ultimately not very good decision by me. Have had many instances of the DJ still being left alive, don't worry. What is his problem? He just needs to die. The best part is when you go through this shebang and the reception's just got nobody. Trying to get in the middle of the dance floor is almost impossible unless you're doing double shot quips, which is not very effective. He will not die to all of the weapons at the moment. This is certainly a curious... happens quite a lot actually, but it's I wish it didn't. It's far too many weapons. Imagine how annoyed casual players must be when this kind of thing happens. Oh no, Thor is gone. Oh! bit rusty on that. I've not done the bosses for a while on that technique. But it's probably quite helpful on this. Jesus! Can I stop getting stuck in his chair? It's constant. It's just endless, man. It's a very interesting theory. I think he's probably just very high on cocaine, but that's fine. It's probably both. Probably, well, you know. Oh, the knife falling aside. I need to stand so vertically over it. He just does not know when to give up as a result of both. He's in just endless patience. Okay, that was annoying. I was standing directly over that, his chair has fucked it up again. Goodness me. How am I looking that up? Oh my god. Just, this is more annoying than waiting for wealth. He really, really, really will not die. What is going on? I mean, come on. It's just silly. This is the perfect situation you're in now. Nearly. Oh, one of the guards came up, that's always not always nice, but usually quite nice. So annoying that the RNG never fucking pans out for a second. Katana, that's always nice. The people, wait a minute. Do I hear someone in this office? No. I never go and check that, I should always just let it find out. Nope. Could have got the knife, but it would be far too slow by that point. I'm standing directly over the knife point. Please. Can it stop flying away? Or not. Great. That's fantastic. Oh my god, please can you stop coming up and running away again? I've only got a big sword. Can the RNG and reception work out one time in the whole round, please? It seems like a few people to be there, and it doesn't work. I was scared about these guys. Kill him. Oh, Jesus Christ! What is wrong with these idiots? They just hit their friend over. I could never have actually killed him on the ground. It just never works, ever. Imbeciles! Oh. going to fight each other in the office, aren't they? Oh my... No, that is outrageous. Anyone want to stand up and be killed, please? Oh my god. Interesting loads. Jesus Christ, it's taking ages! I know it's the first load in, but it's not even usually that long, is it? This is looking pretty unpromising, to be honest. God damn it, that harpoon sometimes. It's pretty special. Pretty insane harpooning skills required for that. Yes, I completely agree with you actually there. That's really true. It's brilliant to play, brilliant OST. Speedrunning is... I have no words for that. I clicked again there, I don't know what happened. Must be the one that I was using. I was not using. Oh, goody. Well, gentlemen, what we're dealing with here is a fucking useless... Okay, really? I'm going back to ESA with that one. I'm very surprised that hasn't happened for ages. I thought my shockwave was pretty good. How did that happen? Oh, I wasn't standing directly over it! Oh my god! Why? Why? I hate the weapon pickup cooldown. Why are there thousands of people in the office? That's never ever helpful. What the fuck was that? Jesus. Didn't used to happen too much. What the hell was that? Everything went wrong again. I don't know how on earth people can enjoy speedrunning this. Tipo says he likes this road level for speedrunning. I don't know how that's possible. Do you think there's something psychologically wrong with it? Oh my god! The chair is so terrible! It is so, so terrible. Why is it a thing? It just ruins everything, that chair. I remember it's been a lot, but that ruins a lot of casual players as well. It's not just a speedrunning issue, that ruins everything. That chair. Pick it up. The game won't let you for hours for some reason at times. Chair is, yes, it's merely a, it's just the guitar boss is front. The boss actually survives this quite easily. What in the fuck is he made of on this level? He's invulnerable, of course. Everything just, you know, surpasses him. I know I only hit him like twice with a knife, but that should be more than enough to kill him with the rest of what I did. No, can you please stop coming in one at a time? It's terrible. Good perception, how about that for once? The disco guards are my least favourite enemy in the entire game, and I'm not joking. They are the most ridiculous, like, they just have a bit more health for no reason. In such a way that makes it really hard to kill them. I am not interested in running heals. It's just endless recycling. The world records for heals are so RNG. I mean, this one I feel like there's still quite a bit of left, and even though you need really good seed from this. So it's just so much resetting required to get heal records. Weirdly good guitar. Should have thrown that in confidence, but that doesn't matter. Yeah, I quite enjoy 100%. It's relatively speaking, it's still playing quite a lot of the game. I do enjoy Beneath when I get wealth, but. Even though it doesn't sound like it, I promise I'm actually having fun playing the game. I'm clicking. I don't know what. Is this just me today? What the fuck just happened with my keyboard? I just pressed the pause button on the timer somehow, even though it's on the other side of the keyboard. Is something else bound to it? What the fuck is wrong with this? Why did that just happen? Why? Why? I did not press 3. I just wanted to use a shockwave. I pressed 1. So definitely press 1. Is tilde doing something? I don't know. I'll be back in a minute. Sorry. Hang on a sec. Yeah. Right, hi, sorry about that. Is anyone at all on YouTube? No, I'm going to end that stream, I think. Save on bandwidth a little bit. Which I apologise for on YouTube. It's not preferable. I'm going to just edit the stream title and everything. There we go, simple adjustment there. Very good. Don't want to restart Pirate Cave. Come back. So, no, you're right, I should enjoy speedrunning, of course. I do, I tend to, it's just the RNG, it's a bit rubbish. Particularly Ills, I think, you get really frustrated with details on the Ills, and 100% there's still just about enough room where I can be a bit relaxed about it and things. Okay. Why did I stop? That was insane. It's so insane I don't even like know what to do now. Chuck's out and blow him. These guys will annoy me later. Find it. Come on, I'm hovering over and I'm releasing E at the correct time. I swear I am, I don't know, there must be nothing in it. Are you kidding me? The pimp is rubbish. In the extreme. Has one of them fallen out? Oh my god! I do really, really hate those enemies. Why do they have the health they do? It doesn't really make any sense. No other enemy in the game really has that, except for that one person on Saloon. Actually, I think it's kind of the same as Biker Boss, isn't it? That you can't really... They do have weak bones, don't they? They're just like mini bosses themselves. It's really silly. Speedrunning purposes, anyway, but their casual is pretty good. I think it's a bit of a surprising, predictable enough challenge. Not really my day on that one. Again. Hello? Hello? Okay, no. I should have taken a gif of that, that's hilarious. The chair was just wrestling me backwards. The
whole time. What the hell? Oh my gosh, please, can people stop coming up one by one? It's so frustrating. That was a poor one. Good, that's probably best that he killed me then, because I would have been disappointed later on. These Poundland katanas that I'm getting. Dollar store katanas for Americans. Anyone else? I don't know. You must have equivalents, but anyway. Stab him in the throat to kill him. That's exactly what I think. You can absolutely go away with that one. So many people coming in one by one again. That is really rubbish, the way the AI works on the first. They immediately run to a completely isolated area of the map to try and kill me. For no reason. That's alright, Trent, no problem at all. Thank you for joining in and discussing stuff like that. I'll see you soon. Of course. And yeah. If I get something of any particular note in the rest of this, PB would be much appreciated, because I didn't even have that good of a world record last time. I thought it was, well, I was pretty surprised that I was on that pace in my run anyway. That was my point about that. Even though I was happy to have it, it was a bad pace probably. Insane. Absolutely insane RNG. What do we make of this then? Difficult one, isn't it? This run, is it any good? Is it rubbish? Pace until the katana fell apart. Excuse me, please. What happened to my kicker? Oh, good lord. Mother of God. Menus barely loading is another annoying thing about this. Ridiculous. What a ridiculous pair of levels we have to start with. Oh. pretty rotten. Oh god, no. What is this, dude? It's just horrific. Invulnerable. Slightly difficult loading screen again with this. I don't really understand why it happens like that so much. But it does. Is anyone gonna die to the actual thing they're meant to die to in this? Interest in this now. What is wrong with it? Oh my god, what is wrong at the start of this? Every person in the disco is just walking up there one by one. This is gonna break before everyone got to the main floor. Yeah, there we go. The RNG on disco does make this such a boring run. It's so fun in certain points, but there's so much of it, it's so frustrating. Three fucking katanas, please just die to one of them. All the ones. Everyone is walking out one by one again! I don't think I can do this anymore. I think this is just not the day. I'm getting too fed up with it too easily. What exactly is wrong with this? I've got so little from today. Every bit of RNG has been against me, more or less. I mean, I've had some good flickers here and there, but it's pretty terrible. I think I'm just gonna say goodbye for the moment. Sorry if that's disappointing, but it's disappointing for me too. The Simpsons comparison of painted sand red characters, that's pretty good. Right. I'm going to depart for the moment, I think. I'll see you soon. Thank you for joining in and everything. I will probably be back with more of the same tomorrow when I've recuperated from this, I imagine. Right, goodbye now. Goodbye.